In this video, you'll see how to develop Java Spring Boot applications with Amazon CodeWhisperer. With this feature, you can use code suggestions to accelerate software development, allowing more time for other tasks, such as ideation, complex problem solving, and writing differentiated code. CodeWhisperer supports many programming languages and development environments. In this demo, we'll use Java and the Spring Boot framework to create a REST API that manages customer information. Spring Boot makes it easy to create standalone, production-grade, Spring-based applications. We'll begin in our IDE, where we have created a Spring project with the following project and configuration details. Let's develop a simple customer entity class that's mapped to our database table. We'll write a comment to prompt CodeWhisperer to generate suggestions. We can cycle through the suggestions using the arrow keys on our keyboard and then press the tab key to accept a specific recommendation. We'll accept CodeWhisperer's suggestions to add the remainder of the implementation. Finally, we'll accept CodeWhisperer's suggestion to add a toString method, which will return the customer's information as a string. Next, let's use the Spring Data Jakarta Persistence API or JPA to persist our data into an H2 in-memory relational database. Let's create a repository interface that uses the customer entity class we just created. Again, we'll write a comment to prompt CodeWhisperer. We now have our repository interface. Next, let's navigate to our application and enter a comment to load some customer data into the database. We'll accept CodeWhisperer's suggestion to use a command line runner interface, which will run after application startup. Next, we'll accept CodeWhisperer's suggested test data. We can add additional test data by pressing Enter to prompt CodeWhisperer to create a new line of code. We'll reject this suggestion and keep the data as is. Next, let's add a customer controller to handle our HTTP requests. We'll write a comment to create a customer REST controller with create, delete, update, and read capabilities. Let's cycle through CodeWhisperer's suggestions. We'll accept this one. Let's continue accepting CodeWhisperer's suggestions to finish the code. Finally, we'll set up a method to get a customer by ID and another to list all the customers from our database. We can manually trigger CodeWhisperer to generate suggestions by pressing Alt-C on Windows or Option-C on a Mac. CodeWhisperer uses the context from this file to recommend both methods. Now let's start our application. Our application has started. Now let's test the methods to create, read, update, and delete customers from the database. We'll begin by reading the list of all our customers. This returns the test data we loaded into the database. Next, let's get the data for a specific customer by providing the customer ID. Here is the data for the customer we specified. Next, let's delete a specific customer from the database. We can list all the customers to ensure the customer was deleted. Finally, let's add a new customer to the database using the specified data. Again, we'll list all the customers to ensure the database was updated. Here is the customer we just added. You've just seen how to develop Java Spring Boot applications with Amazon CodeWhisperer. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.